Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. A few months ago, I decided to make a clay sketch. I wanted to make something simple and not so time consuming, but it transformed into this. Let me explain how that project becomes such complicated. Here we have a clay model from the last videos. Everything started with a 3D scan. Here you can find my video about 3D scanning. But I'll anywhere quickly explain how it works. Back in the day, it was nearly impossible to make a 3D scan at home. I've been making clay models all my life, and I always dreamed about the bridge between the real world and 3D graphics. Now we have a lot of options. Nowadays it's even possible to buy an affordably priced scanner, but I'll use photogrammetry. It requires a phone or a camera and a computer with photogrammetry software. So, how to make a scan? The light must be constant. I will add white stickers to achieve better contrast. Then we have to take photos of a model from different positions. Something like that. Don't move the model or light. Just take photos around it. Don't worry about the messy background. That's even better to calculate all points in space. Okay, let's put photos into the software. I'll use Meshroom. The file with mesh is done. Now you can put it in your software and scale it. That's a great starting point. I use Blender and FreeCAD. Now I can use that scan as a reference for my model. After I made a 3D model, I immediately decided to print it. Here's how many parts are ready at the moment. I will not show you the modeling process, but I'll give you some tips on how to prepare a file for printing. I use Ender 3 Pro, so I have only 220 by 220 by 250 mm. By the way, that's not a sponsored video. Some of the parts are much bigger, so I need to split it. The best way to detach parts is by using existing stitches. For example, door stitches. But sometimes I must split parts in random places. For example, that door is too big to print it in one piece. Of course, you can use only glue, but I like to make locks. The locks are easy to make. I made a 10mm cube. Then I use Boolean operation to cut the 10mm cube with an 8mm cube. Then I hide that cube. And now an important step. I make a 7.8mm cube for the other part of the lock. The reason I make it is simple. Prints always contain some imperfections. So we need to create a gap between the elements. The distance between parts depends on your printer preferences. 7.8mm is okay for my printer, but that number can be different for your printer. Now all we need to do is attach locks to the parts. By the way, keep in mind that the parts for printing are solid. Try to notice surface intersection before printing. Here you can see the mistake I made. On the other side, I fixed it. So, printing pre-production requires a lot of time. I spend almost a week on it. Okay, about the printing. I always try to make parts as thin as possible and place them vertically. For this project, I use 3mm thickness. I try to smooth parts like that to avoid supports. So, about my printing preferences. I use 0.28mm layer height. For that model, it's okay. As a result, I can print parts like that in 11 hours. Okay, a few words about the frame. I made special locks on parts to attach the support structure. Here I made holes for bolts, but then I decided to use a 3D pen. By the way, I'll use a 3D pen to weld the locks on every part. Next time I will show you the complete model. That's it for today. Thank you for watching, guys. I will see you in the next episode.